that's why we don't talk in terms of, now we are talking of the dominant lines, but we never talked about hospital beds per 1,000 population. Because we were not ill. This worldview is very important while analyzing democracy, its survival, challenges before it. Only then we will be able to lead the global society to perpetuate this system of governance, which is the only system where every individual can live with dignity. That is assured. You may question that, no, there are news items every day on the newspaper that somebody threatened a woman, somebody did this. These are aberrations reflecting on the quality of democracy, but not saying that we are not a democracy per se. Regarding, my colleague said, Mr. Lavasa, apathy, 18 to 30 years. Yes, it's real, but it's a symptom. Because as the gadgets become more and more convenient, people become more and more inconvenient. Democracy is about people, not about gadgets. That's the thing. If you catch hold of that during the panel discussion, I think you will be able to find a way to resolve our problems and problems afflicting the global democracy. In fact, the Scottish historian Lord Tytler says that everything is cyclic in this world. So, the democracy, there is also, the cycle is also around 200 years. And he identifies 8 stages from beginning to end and then another cycle. These go from bondage to spiritual faith. From spiritual faith to great courage. From courage to liberty. From liberty to abundance, which was talked about in economic development. From abundance to complacency. From complacency to apathy. From apathy to dependency. And finally, from dependency to bondage.